children, welcome to your bio class. In previous video, we saw respiration in case of human being, and then we discussed about the functions of lungs also. Here we are going to see respiration in different animals. So let's take up with the first one. The first one, as we have already discussed in human beings in detail, is that they can take place through lungs. So organisms such as human beings, birds, reptiles and frogs also, when they are on land, breathe with the help of their lungs. And we have already seen in detail the breathing through lungs in human beings. Frogs, as I told you right now, that when they are on land, they breathe through their lungs. But their lungs are not so powerful and do not expand so much as our lungs do. So this is difference in between the lungs present in frog and human beings. Other organisms here, such as birds and reptiles, do have a set of lungs inside their body, present enclosed within their chest cavity, which help them to breathe. Next, some organisms such as frog, earthworm, leech, etc. breathe through their skin. Children, frog, when they are present in water, can breathe through their skin. Their skin is so moist and slimy that gaseous exchange can take place. They are very, very thin at the same time. Which allows the oxygen, which is dissolved in water, to get entry inside the body, and at the same time carbon dioxide will go outside the body of the frog into the water. So frogs, when present in water, with the help of their moist skin, can take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. This skin, as I have told you, is very thin, moist, clean, and they are directly in touch of the blood vessels, and that is why oxygen, which is dissolved in water, gets deeply into the blood vessels and it is transported to various cells of the body. Similarly, the carbon dioxide, which is produced in various cells of the body with the help of these blood vessels, reaches to the skin and goes out of the body inside the water. So this is how frog breathe when it remains present inside the water. The same thing happens with the earthworm and leech also. For example, the earthworm's skin is also very thin and permeable to the gases. Gases goes inside, rich in the oxygen, goes inside the body of the earthworm, and carbon dioxide goes out of the body of the earthworm through the skin itself. Same thing here is with leech also. Now come to the other organisms which remain in the water all the time. So children, the aquatic animals such as fish, tadpoles and eels breathe with the help of gills. They have gills in the body which help them to breathe. So let's take an example of gills present in the fish body. Inside the water, they can survive only inside the water. And they keep on opening and closing the mouth. In this process, water enters into the mouth and and passes through the gills. Gills have filaments. These are the filaments which are richly supplied with the blood vessels. So as water passes over the gills, the blood vessels which remain attached to the filaments absorb the oxygen dissolved in water, and at the same time they release carbon dioxide which they are bringing from the cells of the fish body. And there is an opening here which is called as operculum. Through this, water rich in carbon dioxide comes out of the body of fish. So this is how fish breathe. Next comes the organisms which are having a kind of holes in their body, and with the help of that they breathe. So children, insects such as cockroaches, mosquitoes, lice, grasshoppers, etc., butterflies, etc. is having holes in their bodies, and these holes are called as spiracles. These spiracles are connected to the tube-like structures, air tube-like structures. These are called as air tubes or tracheae. So, and these air tubes will again be connected to the fine tubular structure which remains in direct contact with the cells of the body of the insect. So, with the help of these holes, air rich in oxygen will enter into the air tubes, and from air tubes it will pass through this tubular structure and finally reach to the body cells. Similarly, the carbon dioxide will come out of the body of the insect. From cells it will enter into the air fine tubular structure, then it will enter into the air tubes. The network of the air tubes called as the trachea, and then finally it will come out through the holes, which are called as spiracles. So this is all regarding breathing or respiration in different types of organisms. In the next video, children, we will discuss about breathing in plants. So till then, goodbye to all of you.